For he did not have a bride. Oh, he sighed, alas, he pined, alas, but alas, the prince couldn't find, alas, who would suit his mother's bride. For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant. But a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. On the stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. A young princess lost was she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said, perhaps, but we'll need some proof. I prepare a test and see. I will test her thus, the old queen said. I'd put 20 downy mattresses upon her bed, and between those 20 downy mattresses, I'd place a tiny pea. If the pea disturbs her slumber, then the true princess is she. Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but a dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Say the queen, my dear, if you felt the pee, then we prove enough of your royalty. Let the wedding music play, and the people shall it quietly. For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant hair, but a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. Many versions of this story. I sing them all. This is the prettiest, but it's not quite accurate. I happen to know the true story of the princess and the pea for the very good reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom ruled over by a attractive queen and a mute king. And the princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test. Actually, she was one of 13 girls. Girls who came to the castle hoping to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived at court, they were testing princess number 12. A kudos quiz was in progress.
Are you ready for the next question?
I guess so.
The next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well then, name three kings Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name three kings.
May I take the third king first? Well then, three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to find out if she's a real princess.
King John, King Arthur, and...
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh yes, if she's a true princess, we can all get married.
King Ethelred.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Because that is absolutely correct!
She's smart, Mama. She's the best one yet. Can I marry her now? Can I, Mama?
No, sweetheart. There's still one more question.
Oh, this test isn't going to be fair. The law isn't
fair. A law?
The marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed to Dauntless at the altar's lead.
Dauntless?
The prince. Until he gets married, none of us can.
You have now reached the seventh plateau, and here is your final question. It is divided into four parts and concerns a famous man, often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. Number one, what was his name? Number two, what beast did he slay? Number three, how many rows of teeth did the beast have, and of what kind? And number four, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, of the best friend, of the blacksmith who forged the sword that slayed the beast?
One, St. George. Two, the dragon. Three, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. And four, would you repeat that last question?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged the sword that slayed the beast?
Middle name.
The middle name.
In-law,
you have 30 seconds.
Pass. Please, please, pass.
Do you speak, my lady?
No, I'm terribly sorry.
20 seconds.
I wish her success. She's a pretty little thing.
10 seconds. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. But it appears your time is up.
Too bad, my dear, too bad. You do show certain aptitude, but as for true brilliance of royalty, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours truly did not. However, to show there are no hard feelings, here's a nice consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, and get out.
Dauntless, stop
pouting. Now don't dilly-dally, it's nearly time for your cocoa. So did I.
Why must every princess get the bird?
I'm sorry. So difficult to pass!
Alas, alas, is what I lack. I lack, alas, alas, a lack.
For living and seeing.
Sir Minstrel, you are just arrived.
Yes, I am, Sir Wizard.
Splendid, splendid. Now watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets. Well, what do you want?
Excuse me, Cardamom, but I have to take our friend the Minstrel to sign in with the castle steward.
This way, please.
I'm on my way to Normandy. I won't be staying long.
Ahem. I put up with a great deal from you for your father's sake. Don't address me as Cardamom in court. Just because your father and I were in show business together, don't presume.
Hello there. And my, I must say, your cheek...
Oh! Sir Harry!
My darling, you missed the test.
Dear Larkin, my new responsibilities as chivalric knight of the Herald keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck. But don't despair, for we have plenty of time. If a true princess is not found in the next few months, I will go out and find one myself. Or I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love.
Do you remember the royal joust on Whit Sunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you, that you might someday become Lord Chamberlain or even Prime Minister?
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
And do you remember the picnic we all had on the greensward later with the lovely colt pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down?
Yes.
And there was a lark singing in the trees, and you said that you would remember that moment forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name?
Yes, Larkin, yes.
And then we watched the sun go down?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. So you see, a princess for Dauntless must be found, and soon, or I shall have to go away somewhere. Oh, darling, I'm so worried. This could ruin you, and you'd never get to be Prime Minister or anything. Say the word, Harry, and I'll go far away where they'll never find you, or me. Just say the word. Harry? Harry?
No! No, you will stay here. Why should we both suffer all our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Harry!
We are none of us perfect. Everything is going to be all right.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't be long, it won't, because it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore I shan't belong to anyone but you. Every small detail, so I
I wish you'd look around until you found a castle in the neighborhood for sale.
Don't dawdle, Dauntless, and pick up your feet when you are walking, and don't look at the sun. I told you not to squint.
Yes, Mama.
Saximus! If I've told you once, I've told you 100,000 times I don't want you playing these foolish games and running around the kingdom. It just isn't dignified. We are rulers of this kingdom, so we must act as one. And if you aren't going to act like one, I'd like to know who will.
Mama. Mama, when am I going to get my princess?
Dauntless. I don't want to discuss this right now. It's time for your cocoa.
But Mama, sometimes I get the funniest feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married. Don't want you to get married. Dauntless. Don't you trust me?
Of course, Mama, but...
Then how can you say such a thing? Dauntless, I want you to get married. It was only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Saximus. I want this boy to get married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. I said, don't forget it. He's next in line for the throne. We're not exactly the oldest people in the world, but we're not going to live forever. So I would feel much easier and more relaxed in my mind if that boy was married, settled, and set. And that is absolutely verbatim exactly what I said to your father this morning. He never said anything, of course. He never does, but I don't have to tell you that. He may make me miserable and make me suffer, but I just have to put up with it. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father. There is only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your health and your future, and that is what I'm talking about right now. Your future. Now, let me make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, Dauntless, but I don't want you to just marry anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want you to end up miserable like I did. So, you must marry a princess.
But there were 12.
A real princess, a genuine, bona fide princess, just like I was. Oh, that's what you want, right? Someone like me? Just remember this. You must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Oh, hello, Harry.
Don't interrupt. Well?
Sir Harry wishes to speak with you, madam.
Well?
Your Majesty, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to go out in search of a true princess, a princess who will suit both yourself and Prince Don.
No.
Mama.
No, no, no. We've been through all of the eligible girls in the kingdom. There are none left. We simply have to wait till their little sisters grow up, and that'll take years.
But, madam, I plan to head north over the mountains.
Over the mountains.
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands.
And into the marshland where the beautiful swamp lily grows.
Into the marshland! Are you out of your mind?
Let him go, Mama. Let him go.
You won't find anything there but frogs and tadpoles and things.
Mama.
Do you know what the weather there is like?
Mama, please.
Do you know how foggy and damp?
Mama.
And humid and oppressive.
Mama,
and...
let Sir Harry try for me, please.
All right. Off with you.
Hooray.
Now, come on, Dauntless. You've missed your cocoa.
Good luck, Harry. Good luck.
Don't be afraid, little Larkin. I'll bring back a real princess. A princess who will pass the Queen's test.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away too long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We'll be waiting for you.
We?
You know.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4.
In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I have it planned. but I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. In a velvet gown, you'll be coming down the aisle, and it's bound to seem as though the waiting's only been a little, in a little while.
Sir Harry's perilous journey took 3 weeks, and the Lady Locking had all but given up hope that he would find the true princess. Then one sunny morning in the mid-April, when the crocus is just beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in a northbound tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry is back. Sir Harry is back with the new princess. Now let's see. How does this part go in the old story?
On the stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for.
That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't storm that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night. And the princess only looked as though she'd come from a storm.
To stop her, but she wouldn't wait for the drawbridge.
You swam the moat.
She seemed determined to arrive as soon as possible. We had to get a rope and pull her out.
You swam the moat.
All right. I was a little anxious, but my friend Sir Harry... He's still out there. He told me you had an opening for a princess. Any princess, and I figured the early bird. Anyway, here I am. Who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Or you, or you, or you, or you?
No, no, no.
I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I confess it, I'm shy. Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear? 'Cause I'm shy. And you may be sure, way down deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it at bottom, tend to be strong, but as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try, though I'm frightened and shy. Despite the impression I give, I confess I'm living a lie. Because I'm actually terribly timid and dripping with glamour, as often as not, she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. She's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. I often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate. I'm gonna look in every brook. But how much longer must I wait with bated breath and hook?
Yourself.
Good idea. Do you ever say anything except...
Do you mean to ask me to believe that you are a true princess of royal blood? Oh, and am I actually to understand that you have the nerve, the gall, and the presumption to ask for my son's hand in marriage?
Mama, may I say something?
Quiet! And do you think even for one moment I would consider you suitable for any son of mine? You are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. My son isn't going to marry any boat swimmer. Not while I have breath in my body. Oh, and I'm not feeling well, not well at all. Oh, I get these shooting pains all through here. Don't tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had the vapors.
You're new here. Watch closely.
Oh,
I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment. Now notice that it is a single piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
It's a nut house.
Oh, goody.
No, wait.
You're the one, I guess.
Sure, I'm Dauntless the Drab.
Well, glad to have met you.
No, 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 please don't go. I like you.
Oh.
Everybody does. Well, almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but well, I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother. So I guess I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamps.
But I really like you.
You do? Why?
You swam the moat.
Dauntless, I know I swam the moat, but that's not me. I'm not like that. Actually, I'm Shuckshot!
No! She's in the moat. Again.
Lower the drawbridge.
Are you all right, ma'am?
Sure. You ought to see her swim, Mama. She's wonderful.
Yes, isn't she?
I like her, Mama. She swam the moat.
It's cold.
Twice.
I don't need any help.
Can I marry her, Mama? Can I?
Marry her? Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a real...
And just interrupt me.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred.
princess.
Ah, but she is, Your Majesty.
What?
That one, you
jizz. On my honor as a knight, I swear she is. I have her papers right here. Winifred, Princess of Icomkill, Guardian of the Midgard Serpent, and Warden of the Ragnarok Marsh Lily. The inscription on her family crest reads...
To Miss Ed.
Something in Latin.
What does it mean?
If at first you don't succeed...
If at first you don't...
Never mind!
You see, she is a princess. At least a test, Mama. For me, please.
All right. We'll test her. The wizard and I will put on our thinking caps, and I'll prove to you that this girl cannot possibly be a princess.
Give her my leg!
We'll test her for... Crude! We'll test her for sensitivity. She'll have her tests, and she'll fail like all the others. Fair and square. Fail what?
The royalty test.
Every princess suing for my hand must pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
Well, what kind of test?
It's always highly secret.
Oh, well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I need to get out of these wet clothes.
Maisha, you're part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure!
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
You're good looking, too.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
I'm so excited. Sir Harry is back. Yes, he is, and he's brought us a sweet princess. Have you seen her?
Neither have I, but I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom. And I'm to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything.
You know, my father expected me to follow in his footsteps, but then I landed this jester job and... What's wrong? You're worried? About what? Who? Some lady? Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable? Oh, bird. Some kind of bird.
A bird.
Bluebird, catbird, dove, eagle, finch, grouse, ibis, jay, kiwi, lark, martin? Lark. Lark?
A Lady Larkin!
And? A knight?
Which knight?
Sir Harry! Dust. Dust. Oh, sounds like dust. Lust?
No.
What?
Must. Must what? You're going to start all over, right?
Oh! She's going to have a baby. Does anyone else know? Sir Harry?
Of course, but does anyone else know besides Sir Harry?
Don't worry. We can keep a secret. The question is, can you?
We have only two voices among us, and yet there's a third voice, a voice in disguise. You'll be hearing a trio and not a duet if you listen with both of your eyes. Kindly, with both of your... We produce a unique and remarkable blend when we raise our three voices on high. We're imperfect, of course, from beginning to
the king and the minstrel and I.
Yet if one of our trio should ever depart, then the others will languish or die. We're like three different people, if only one, the king and the jester and I. Sing hey, nanny, nanny, hey, nanny, nanny, hi, diddle, diddle. Strike up a tune on the... Oh, the bishop declares our behavior is rude as he piously looks to the sky. Cause when we go in swimming, we always go the king and the jester.
The king and the minstrel.
The bitter makes wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 bellows were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody but... Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate cream roll and a fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastry and filling up? Sing hey, nanny, nanny, hey, nanny, nanny, needle and thimble. Crash us a crash on the... It's been said of our king that his mortals are loose, but the queen is much worse on the sly. Cause what's good for the gander is good for the... See the king and the jester.
The king and the minstrel.
Trouble trying to protect my only son from the ever-catch-penny princess that comes along. And now I'm surrounded by spies and traitors. Oh, whom can I trust?
Me.
No one. And now I have another one of those princesses to cope with. I'm in no mood to sit in a stuffy chamber and wrap my brain for a test when I'm not feeling well. But... that's the way Dauntless wants it. That's the way it'll be. She'll have her test.
Well, her papers seem to be in order.
I know. And the weird thing is that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair, sounds fair, seems fair, and isn't fair. When you got the idea of testing her for sensitivity, I could have applauded right out loud, but exactly what?
Table manners?
No, not good enough. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet.
This is the blessing.
Also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. Suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me! Think of a tricky test for that wretched moat-swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest that maybe we ought to...
Don't take all night, I'm not well, I need my rest. Not that I'll ever sleep on that lumpy mattress. Oh gosh, my back! Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer, under the mattress. We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress. Oh gosh, you're bright.
any genuine princess would feel it if she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea and order one mattress. No, make it do.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps. We'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning. Oh, but you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive, she'll fall asleep, no doubt. God, but you're clever. Genius, you are divine, get out!
I live here.
So?
Well, it sure feels nice to get into something dry. These old clothes are just soaked.
Your Highness? The king has requested to meet the young lady.
Why? He's never asked before.
He heard that she swam the moat.
Is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is...
No, my father's silent.
Oh, I'd love to meet him.
Papa, this is Princess Winifred.
Highness, the king welcomes you, and he has asked me to tell you that he hopes you get a 100 on the test tomorrow.
Oh, thanks.
My father never touches his crown to his heart unless he really means it.
Oh, alas, madame, the king is mute, or he would speak for himself. He's still under a curse cast by a witch many years ago, before Dauntless was born. Well, the curse says that King Sextimus shall never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk? Oh, well, can't you just get a big mouse and a little hawk?
We tried that once. The mouse got scared and ran away, and the hawk bit Daddy.
Well, let me just get this test under my belt. And we'll figure something out! Don't worry! Yeah, it certainly... Well, it certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty. Now, that's a nice man.
Your Majesty. I think you better talk to Dauntless very soon about, you know...
About what?
Your father feels he's been neglecting his duty, and now that you're old enough to get married, he thinks you two ought to have a little talk, you know? Man to man.
You mean about things? Right now?
Well, your father says it might be better to wait until later. There are a few facts he wants to look up first, so.
Oh, well, I certainly do like almost both of your parents, Dauntless.
We want you to be happy here. We know it's a little different from what you might be used to.
Well, it certainly has been hard making the adjustment to dry land and everything.
You must feel like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. Back home in the swamp, we don't have any dry land. Sure, some of the poorer people do, but all the nobility live right in the swamps with their servants and pets.
Oh, you have pets?
What?
Dogs?
Frogs. I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. Ooh. We're walking through the meadow in the morning. It's like walking through Goliath.
Majesty, the girls and I would like to lend you something to wear while your, garment is drying.
Oh, why, thanks!
Ladies?
Oh, Dauntless, I have to change now.
You do? Oh, all right.
No, Dauntless, it's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding.
Highness, would you like to see the gowns now?
Yes!
Now, this is the very lady to speak from. And they do such lovely work, don't they? There's the fullness in the back, and the window sleeves cut right down to the... Oh, it's really you. It looks marvelous on. Right, Lady H?
Stunning!
Would you like to look in the mirror now?
Does Her Highness have a favorite color?
Well, back home we wear a lot of dark browns and earth greens, but I guess my favorite color would have to be that dress, Huckleberry. Tell you what, leave them here and whatever I can't use, I'll send back.
Very good. Lady H, Lady R.
I won't need you, Emily. They've already sent up a girl to clean the floors. You're new here, aren't you?
Yes, I...
Well, remember, we all have a job to do, and your job is just as important as anyone else's. Oh, dear, sweet, lovely Princess Winifred, you will pass the Queen's test. You will. Gramercy, my dear, you can't possibly clean the floor with such a tiny patch. You need a good big wet rag. Here, what's... Oh, this...
Oh, that's my trap.
Use this old thing. If I can get it. That is the question.
That's my dress.
Well then, you should have no problem cleaning with it. Now look at this mess. What will my gentle princess think of me? Can you know what it means to be lady-in-waiting to the blessed Winifred? Oh, Winifred, Winifred, what name is sweeter than that? Another table's dripping wet. I'll just have to take these. Oh, would you get the door, please? Quick, quick, quick.
Come in! Harry!
Your Highness.
Your what?
How are you? Oh, get up. You don't have to go through those motions with me. Oh, say, I'm sorry about the whole, swimming in the moat thing. I hope I didn't make too bad of an impression.
Not at all. And if you'll just give your address to one of the ladies in waiting, she'll see that it's taken care of.
Thanks, but it's already been done.
I see you've met my lovely Lady Larkin.
Oh, so this is your little Larkin girl.
The very same.
Oh, Harry, she's beautiful. Quite the ball of energy.
Every time I gaze on that captivating face, I realize how poor my descriptions must have been.
Sir Harry is not very good at describing people.
Well, he may not be good at describing them, but he sure knows how to pick them. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get these to the, fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my life.
What?
I thought she was a chambermaid.
A chambermaid?
A chambermaid.
Larkin, how could you mistake the princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess?
Don't say such a thing just because you made a stupid mistake.
I made a mistake? Don't you dare try to blame this on me.
I do blame it on you.
She was on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor.
She is a princess no matter where she was, and that is more than I can say for some people around here.
I hate you.
I hate you too.
Get out.
I'm going.
Goodbye.
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 After all, you're a wizard, so make sure to whip up that sleeping potion. Ooh, and that good heavy incense.
Oh, and the hypnotic mirror, too. Oh, I forgot the most important part. She must be tired out first. We'll have an official ball tonight. We'll make what's-her-name dance until she drops. Does anyone know the Saracen ball? No. Not tiring enough. Oh, we'll do that new dance, the Spanish Panic. It's absolutely exhausting. Do you know it? Well, it's the rage in Venice. It's simple. I'll teach it. Ready? Open your skirts, open, close, right, right, with a little magic step only forward. Just that simple. Suppose we all try it? One, two, three. Flip your skirts, open, close, right, right, wrong. Does anyone know the Spanish Panic?
We do, Your Majesty.
Thank heaven someone's up to date around here. Why don't we all watch while Sir Lucia and Lady Beatrice demonstrate? Now, does that look hard? Suppose we all try to grab partners and prepare. Doesn't it make you want to fly?
Has he ever had any success?
Well,
I've been here a month, but he hasn't caught a girl yet.
I'll tell you what, tomorrow, we'll set a trap.
You exaggerate.
Not a bit. Someone's coming? Who?
The Queen!
And this has to be the biggest, most loudest ball in all of the kingdom. So make sure to hire some extra musicians. Oh, and I want the jester to perform. Ugh, not that I'll enjoy it with my back and all. And this nagging pain in my jaw. No one will ever know what I suffer. Wizard!
Oh, is she jabbering about? The Queen's going to make us do something?
What?
Exercise?
Who is it?
I don't know. Where am I supposed to hide? Oh, my lady! Is there something wrong?
No.
Well, we're glad of that anyway.
I was simply sitting in my room sewing and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out here and get some air.
I see you were planning on camping out for a while.
Your Majesty. Oh, you don't know, you just don't know. Have you any idea what can happen to the relationship between a man and a woman? I'm glad I found out when I did. It's better this way. I'm leaving.
You are leaving?
Yes, I'm leaving the service of the Queen forever.
It's a pretty big step to take all alone.
I have no choice.
You are leaving forever?
Yes.
You'll need help.
Who would help me?
I, my lady.
Well, what'd you say?
You're going to take care of Lady Larkin. Who's going to take care of you? Yeah, that makes sense.
Chivalry demands that we protect a damsel in distress.
Well, if you say so, Your Majesty.
But she'd have to travel light the way a man does.
Yes, she'll go as a boy. We can still win Prince Dauntless' suits. We'll get these things out of sight. You can wait in your room.
No, thank you. I don't need help from anyone. I can go alone.
Over the wall?
Yes, I don't need help from anyone.
You'll be all right once you get past the water rat.
Rats?
Oh, yes, they live by the stagnant pools near the quicksand.
Quicksand?
Beyond the wall, which you must climb.
Climb?
It's 20 feet, and covered with slime.
Slime?
Oh, you visit me, spiders.
Spiders?
Spiders are sweet compared to the snakes.
Snakes?
On the other side.
Well, they won't hurt you. Unless, of course, you plan to go alone.
Well, I did, but if I'd known it was so terrible out there.
Then you think I'll take off and come with me. I know all the secret way to get us free. Over the hills and to the open sea.
Open sea? Where?
It's April, isn't it?
April?
Normandy is fine and fair. So Normandy is where we'll go.
I can show you a beach where the peach blossom blows, and I know how to reach a man who knows a man who knows a
cozy inn, a friendly place with rows of window facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy.
I know the meadow covered with mustard flower, golden as the sun. Where the wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. There's a moment after the sunset when the sky is suddenly green, and the walls stand hushed and waiting for the first white star to come in. When you see that emerald sky, you know the reason why. There's not another place I'd rather be.
Keep your Eldorado, and to hell with Burgundy.
Come fly with me.
Come try those wings. Come sweat, for we have things to do. On wind of facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is red and green. Don't be afraid, heaven was made in Normandy.
Sir Harry, he's had a fight with Lady Larkin. Oh, wait, he's actually right over there.
Oh, he's with that French girl. She only speaks one word of English, but I hear she's a real charmer.
Well, what's the one word?
Yes!
Oh. Hey, Harry, old boy, how are you?
Très bien.
We're having a party on the West Barrett Bay later. You should come, and don't forget to bring the wine.
Oh, it's something to spread on the ground.
And ask Maybelle if she'd like to come, too.
Voulez-vous?
Yes!
Let's go again!
Excuse me, Sir Sudley. Do you know where the solarium is?
Oh, yeah, sure thing. It's, oh, that way.
Wow.
Here, why don't I just show you?
Maybe you could give me a clue.
A clue?
I know it's highly secret, but... What kind of test does she usually give?
Well, with Mama thinking of the test, it could be almost anything.
Like what?
Sometimes it's dancing. Sometimes it's history. Sometimes it's geography. Sometimes it's even archery. But sometimes it's a test of strength and endurance.
Uh-huh.
For instance, one of the girls had to lift that weight. She couldn't. I can't even lift it. But I know you'll pass. You don't have to worry.
Well, do you want me to pass? All right, I'll pass. Yeah.
The queen insists on quiet. She's ordered 20 mattresses, the softest and the best, and she's threatened execution if we dare to.
Trust you, you pilots! What is going on here? What are you up to? What? There's something going on here. What's under the mattress? It's a dead body. Get off. Pull that away. What is going on here? Explain yourself.
It's just a joke, Your Majesty. This boy and I go outside and wait for me. Lancelot.
Lancelot? That doesn't look like a lance. Lady Larkin! Bring those things to what's-her-name's chamber. Mattresses, too.
Your Majesty.
What are you doing in this ridiculous ghetto? And why weren't you at the ball?
Please, I just...
Majesty.
Shut up! And what are you doing with this man?
Majesty, please.
Answer me.
Please, I beg of you.
You were running away. Is that it? You were running away.
Larkin?
Why, you low-born, ungrateful little sneak! Is this the thanks I get for treating you as my own daughter? And now look at you, running off with a musician.
Majesty, Lady Larkin is innocent.
Yes.
I'll tell you the truth.
Yes.
I forced her to leave against her will.
Yes, but what? No.
Why, you low...
Just a moment.
Larkin, what are you doing with that man?
What were you doing with that woman?
You, go to your room.
Don't you tell me what to do, you...
Quiet! May I remind you that you are still one of my ladies in waiting. Go upstairs where you belong and put what's-her-name to bed.
Majesty.
Do as I say. And Sir Harry, may I remind you that you are still one of my knights. Step forward. Sir Harry, I want this minstrel banished from the kingdom. I want him out by daybreak. Saximans! Go to bed. I don't want you groping around in the night. Now, everybody listen up. There is a girl upstairs who is dog-tired.
Oh, no. She said she was going to study for her test.
All right. Let her study. But when she's done, I want quiet around here. I want quiet, and I'm going to get quiet if I have to scrape the palace down.
Okay, Skidoo.
Quiet!
P-H-O-B-I-A. Trichodecaphobia.
Good wealth, Mama. Test you in literature or spelling. You're sure to pass, Fred. That leaves history.
History takes in quite a lot, but let's give it a whirl.
The first chapter is called, Ooh, the Bravery of Prince Waldare.
Waldare?
Young Waldare, wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Who?
Wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Oh, yeah, Fafnir. That one.
Takes his father's sword, Minning.
Minning?
Disguised as the West Wind, Waldare goes into the forest, surprises Fafnir in his lair, and slays him, whereupon he's enabled to understand the speech of birds. Meanwhile, Albrecht, Waldare's father, disguised as the sacred goat, sets up the spirit of Gunnthyr.
Oh, yeah, Gunnthyr. Right. But I thought... Oh, did you ring for a page boy?
No.
Well, you have the wrong room, son. Wait a minute. Aren't you Larkin?
What's the matter?
I have a suit just like that.
I am in disguise, Your Highness. I was running away.
I see. Well, sit here and we'll talk about it. Dauntless, grab that chair.
But the queen has ordered...
Oh, never mind what the queen has ordered. Just sit.
But, Your Majesty...
Sit. Now, what happened?
I'll just go out on that parapet and stand there naked and catch a chill and die, and that'll show him.
Show him what?
He'll be sorry.
Who?
Horrible Harry.
You mean wonderful, nice Harry?
Just a minute. What did you do to him?
What did I do to him?
Well, you must have done something. You're talking the way I once did when I was so scared to go home because I'd given my little brother a bloody lip. It was an accident.
We had a little disagreement.
So you decided to run away?
He said some perfectly horrible things to me.
Oh, I see. I guess you're right. I guess there is nothing more for you to do than simply pack up and get out. Unless you go to him and say you're sorry. Listen, that Harry's a wonderful boy, and he really loves you. Why, we were on the road for 2 weeks, and he never laid a finger on me.
Your Highness.
Now, you just go get into something that makes you look like a girl. And Larkin, try and act a little helpless. Men don't like women that are too strong.
I do.
Dear Princess, I don't know how to thank you. If it's a girl, I'm going to name her Fred.
But what if it's a boy?
Dauntless, you better go to bed and leave the history book.
I'm positive you're going to pass Mama's test tomorrow. Well, I'm pretty sure. If you don't...
And so, having slain the dragon Fafnir with the sword Minning, young Prince Valdir rescued the Princess Trigga, and they mounted his horse Frigga. And they rode to the castle Vonderbar, where they were married and lived happily ever after. Well, I'm glad. Happily, happily, happily ever after. The couple is happily leaving the chapel eternally tied. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heroine's always the bride. Ella, the girl of a cinder, did the washing, the walls, and the winders, till she landed a prince who was brawny. Cinderella had outside help. I have no one but me. Fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I haven't got a fairy godmother. Well, I haven't got a godmother. I have a mother, a plain, ordinary woman. Snow White was so pretty, they tell us, that the queen was insulted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but was saved by some men who adored her. Oh, I grant you, they were small, but there were 7 of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night, by myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had 7 determined little men working day and night just for her. Oh, sure, the queen gave her a poison apple. Even so, she lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have done.
power for years by a wicked old witch. Till one night in despair down, she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite a switch. Oh, I wonder. No, it'll never work. I'll be finished before I begin. And besides, I don't want to get out. I want to get in. I want to live happily, happily, happily ever after. I want to walk happily out of the chapel eternally.
Transporting a woman out of kingdom, that is a serious offense.
He didn't do it, it was a frame-up!
You've got it all wrong!
He was trying to protect the Lady Larkin, and you keep helping, Your Majesty!
Sir Harry, I cannot leave yet. There is someone I must see first.
Who?
The wizard. I want your permission to speak to the wizard.
Yes, yes!
No, permission denied.
Sir Harry, you are a pheasant!
Yes, yes you are! He's trying to help, we're all trying to help!
How can you help?
By finding out what the test is from the wizard.
That would be cheating.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let me go to the wizard.
No. If anyone should defy the wizard's magic, I should.
No! No, 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 no. You must stand guard this. This is my job. I know, you might get hurt. You can't come and that's final.
Matter, Papa. The king can't come.
All rid of him. Oh, Your Majesty, Prince Dauntless is ready now. He needs to have that personal talk with you.
Some other time.
Dauntless, your father wants to have that chat with you now. It's very important.
It is.
Can't be put off. Come on. Do your duty, sire.
Well, what do you want to talk about, Papa? Papa? Stop. Look, listen. Me. Smaller? Little me. Oh, boy. Flower. Girl. Flower. Boy, flower, girl, flower. Oh, tell me. I want to know about what getting married is for. Oh, see. Fall. From girl flower. And by, baby flower grow. All but try. Oh, tell me why. Oh, Father, tell me, Father, don't be shy. Boy flower, girl flower. Love each other. Boy flower, father. Girl flower, mother. Yes, yes, but how? It's very interesting, but how? Oh, tell me now. On boy flower dust gets on bee. Bee flies to girl flower, dust touches girl flower. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting.
interesting, but still not clear to me. Woman is like girl flower. Man is like bee. And like boy flower. Man, that's me. But tell me more. I've got to know about what getting married is for. Sounds like Harry. Mary. Man and woman get married. Winifred and White. Love each other. Night. And then one night. Yes, yes, one night. It's very interesting what happens in the night. What happens? Oh, tell me, Father, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Oh, Princess Winifred and I will get married. And then one night. A baby. Oh, Papa, I know about the stork. Mama told me about that years ago. My name is Papa. Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork at all. Oh, life is grand. It's very interesting. I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father. And Father, I love you so.
Look, buddy, I'm doing something here. Mm-hmm. Now that's off.
Pardon, Sir Wizard.
What do you want?
Our friend the minstrel is a great admirer of yours.
No soft soap, if you please.
This is not soft soap. And I wouldn't even say it, except the fact I've been banished. And before I go, well, I hope it won't embarrass you, but I had to tell you what a great artist you are, Cardamon.
Cardamon? Now that's a name I've not heard in a long time. Long time.
I use this name with honor, sir. I don't think I'll ever forget seeing you in common show at Glastonbury in 92. What a show, what a success. You took... Seven curtain calls.
Eight.
Do you happen to remember a little boy in a second row who stood up and yelled bravo that night?
Yes.
I was that boy.
I can't believe it.
Of course. And now I'm in show business too. And sir, if it's any interest to you, it was your inspiration that brought this about.
You must belong to the guild.
Hey, nanny, nanny, talking. Hey, nanny, nanny. Camelot Local 714. To think someone still remembers those days.
Yes. Well, I just wanted to tell you what the performance meant to me, Cardamon. I'd better be going now.
No. Sir Minstrel. For you.
Thank you.
Here, have a seat.
No, the queen wouldn't like it if she knew that I was still here.
Never mind her. This is between us. And sit down.
Anyway, you are probably busy with the test for tomorrow.
That's all right. The test is all taken care of.
I don't suppose you could tell an old guild brother what it is.
Well, I'm sort of under oath.
I understand. Well, I'd better be going now.
Wait. Sir Minstrel, may I borrow your handkerchief?
What handkerchief?
Now watch this one. You know, some people say that my act is pretty foul.
Cardamon the Great!
I'll bet you'll never guess what the test is about.
Astronomy?
No, you'll never guess. Sensitivity.
Sensitivity? Did you hear?
The greatest. Now let me tell you the rest. You know, I'd better not.
I'll go. But before I do, Cardamon, may I keep this?
What do you want with that?
Oh, you know, just a memento for the good old days. Because my father.
Keep it.
Thank you, sir.
And Jester. No, we are not there yet. No.
Oh. Sorry, I know we're having a moment. I was kind of feeling.
You know, next time.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't really want to do it anyways. Yeah, it's fine. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yikes.
That was a wonderful thing you did for him, Cotterman.
Well, you know, for his father's sake.
Say, I don't actually have to get out of here until daybreak. Why don't we go down to the wine cellar, split the bottle, and catch up?
Fine, but I've started something here that I'd like to finish. You go ahead, and I'll join you in 2 seconds.
I'd be waiting.
Yeah.
But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me if I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do in the days when my dear father played the palace. Back in 1392, my dad was debonair and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the people say, he's a regular dancing fool. he barely touched the ground and never made a sound. But I noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd and the crown, the crowd went crazy and the house came down when Daddy wore his very soft shoes.
There? Friend or foe?
Friend, I hope.
Oh.
Harry, look at me. I was trying to run away, but it's only because I thought you didn't love me anymore. I thought you didn't love me. Even if you don't love me, I can't love anyone but you, and I want to be near you if I can, for as long as I can. Harry, I don't blame you if you've changed.
Well, in a way, I have. Yesterday, I loved you as never before. But please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change, and today I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning, I openly confess. Tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow morning.
Yesterday I loved you as never before, but that was long ago, and now it's best you
anyone ever could be. Now I see what tricks my eyes can play. Yesterday I must have been utterly blind, or else I was out of my mind, for I find you so much lovelier today. My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning. Yesterday I loved you as never before, but please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change, and today I love you even more.
lords cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning. I openly confess. Tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow morning.
Some
kind of loon? Mother, fix it.
Leave me alone, Mama. I can dress myself.
Far for me to be to intervene, precious.
I said I can do it.
Why are you dressed like that so early in the morning?
Well, today's the test, and I want to look my best for it.
The test? Dauntless, the test is over.
Huh?
The test is over, darling boy.
But when was it? What was it?
It was last night. We put her to bed under 20 soft, downy mattresses with a pea under the bottom one to test her sensitivity. And of course, the pea would have kept a real princess awake.
And she slept?
Well, I'm not sure. But she was practically dying from exhaustion when she walked in and yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. And I mean, she looked ghastly. And old enough to be your mother. Well, we'll see.
Oh, Fred.
Under 20 mattresses, huh? Oh, no,
Don't you think she's pretty?
No, she's not pretty. She's beautiful. 20 mattresses, huh? Dauntless, I'll leave the wedding arrangements up to you. You better start looking for a small kingdom for us, because I have a feeling we aren't going to want to be living with your mother. Oh, a good change, right? Now you're going to say the good change again. So funny. Ah ha ha, I'm laughing.
She's going to get cold sleep, so I better take her up to her room.
Dauntless! Wait.
Wait for what, Mama?
To put this matter into some proper consideration.
What is there to consider? She passed the test.
Throughout this heartbreaking process, I have never nagged, never intervened, and never asked for one solitary word of sympathy. I mean, I know she passed the test, but I don't want you throwing yourself away on this little nobody.
Quiet.
I mean, I never trusted anyone with those shifty little eyes and that mean little mouth and nose.
Shut up!
It happened! The prophecy! The mouse devoured the hawk! What?
I can talk and I've got a lot to say.
What?
That's right, Agravain. I've held this in for 20 years and not a minute more. Ye are the pheasant!
Aggravate!
There's going to be a few changes around here. For starters, every time that I say hop, I want you to hop. Okay? So, go ahead, give us the hop.
I said hop!
Very good. And now a little skip. Excellent! Alright, now let's jump. That's it, yeah!